Hello, my name is Hannah and I'm a new generation volunteer from Nebraska. Today I will be talking about the Beanie Bear craze of the 1990s, as well as the history of Beanie Bears themselves. My information for today's video came from withotis.com and fundinguniverse.com. The history of Beanie Bears is a really unique and interesting one. However, my experience with Beanie Bears is interesting as well. The first time I was ever exposed to a Beanie Bear was in kindergarten when I won a tie-dye Beanie Bear out of a treasure chest. This is the exact Beanie Bear, its name is Groovy, and I still have him to this day. This experience of winning a Beanie Bear out of a treasure box really touched me and stemmed my love for stuffed animals, collectibles themselves, as well as now, as an adult, finding Beanie Bears and reselling them. The history of Beanie Bears began in 1992 when H. Ty Warner tried to come up with a new toy for the Atlanta Toy Fair in 1992. He decided to sell these toys for $5 due to their being posable due to being filled with beans. However, the craze for Beanie Bears really took off in 1993 when Ty decided to retire bears when they were still in circulation. This caused the demand for these Beanie Bears to skyrocket, and people would often go to stores to look for these bears and snatch them up before they sold out. These bears would often be collectible if they were in certain conditions, such as having the heart tag preserved or being filled with PVC pellets instead of PE pellets. My Beanie Bear collection, pictured here, most of them are filled with PE pellets due to them not being very valuable. However, I do have one Beanie Bear that is filled with PVC pellets that is very rare and collectible. When the emergence of eBay caused the Beanie Bear market to really boom even more. In 1998, the Thai Beanie Bear factory market was valued at $1 billion. And then in 1998, Thai decided to quit making Beanie Bears. This caused people to want to purchase Beanie Bears even more than they already did. This made the resale market for Thai Beanie Bears skyrocket. And even though some of these bears were deemed unvaluable before due to being made with PE pellets, people having the desire to own certain animals, such as Splash the Crab or the Princess Diana Bear, caused people to buy the even unvaluabler ones. However, in 2000, the resale market for Beanie Bears crashed due to Furbies topping the Christmas wish list for children more than Beanie Bears have. Today, the resale market for Beanie Bears is down very bad. However, some Beanie Bears are still worth a lot of money, such as first editions. The Princess Diana Bear, with mint condition, with the heart tag still attached, with the PVC pellets, is worth $550. The Beanie Bear market never resurged due to never changing and never developing the bears into a cool new trend and just keeping the bears original. However, Ty, in the late 2010s, decided to emerge with Beanie Boos to capture a younger crowd. I know myself and my friends would collect Beanie Boos in elementary school and middle school. However, Beanie Bears still have a nostalgia factor for adults, and adults will still go on hunts in thrift stores or even on eBay, or there are even conventions where people will go and trade their Beanie Bears in order to acquire more. There is also a Beanie Bear website where people will rate the condition of their Beanie Bears in order to see if they are rare or valuable. I know me myself, part of the fun and not even in reselling the Beanie Bears is going to a thrift store with friends and seeing what bears that there is there, because there are certain bears that I would like in order to collect, in order to grow my collection of Beanie Bears and have enough to give to my future children. Beanie Bears are very nostalgia for people old and new. However, Beanie Bears will probably never emerge as a trendy toy again due to other toys and stuffed animals becoming more trendy. In 2020, there was the emergence of Squishmallows that many children wanted to buy. These Squishmallows were off the market for many years, many months, being very hard to find due to the demand being so high, and TikTok, the app, causing them to not be able to be found in stores. I myself am very interested in Squishmallows as well as Beanie Bears, and I try to have a large collection of each. However, for me now, while the Squishmallow demand was so high and they were unavailable in stores, it caused me to look and develop my collection of Beanie Bears even more. The history of Beanie Bears is a rich history, and it will grow in the future by having many people still be willing to trade and collect more. Thank you.